Christian Ak here. It's CES 2024. I'm in the Swave suite. They're having their little reception right now. Beers, chocolates, and holograms. So let's talk about holograms. What they've developed is actually a very, very interesting new technology. I've said for a while that we, if we're going to go to true holography and or light field displays, pushing the current technologies is kind of probably not going to get us there. So what they developed is of technology that was leveraged from the memory memory area, and it's based on chalcogen phase change materials. So this technology was developed a number of years ago, again for memory circuits, but it never really adopted the full commercialization potential that had happened. The problems were that there was drift in the memory circuits, and there's deterioration after a number of cycles. And the reason for that was because of the current that would pass through the phase change material. Now, this phase change material is activated by heat, so it's a binary material. What S-Wave has done is changed the configuration of this. So they have a CMOS backplane. And with an air gap and with the phase change material on top of it. It's basically a little resistive heater on top of the CMOS, which creates a little pulse of heat, which is enough to change the phase of that material. So basically, it's a binary material. That ability allows it to write a diffractive pattern, a binary diffractive pattern to a material. Now, the big advantage of this material is that you can make really, really tiny pixels or elements. In the demo that they're showing here, we're talking a quarter of a micron material. So what they're showing is, and a little demo here, is a device that is actually 32K by 32K in an 8x8 millimeter device. So that's basically a quarter micron pixels, and so I was able to put my eye on this. It's you can use your naked eye to see the holographic image. It's tiny. It's a small device. I'll show you a picture of what I saw. It's a kind of a pot marked moon, if you will, but it's clearly visible with the naked eye. And it can be manufactured now on 12-inch silicon fabs. This technology came out of IMAC, the Belgian research firm, said that had been working on it for 10 years now. So the ability of this material is it can be used in two basic applications. One for an AR application. You can put this little display device in the temple of the frame of the eyeglasses. You do not need a waveguide. All you need is a little holographic reflector in the top of the glass, and it's going to beam that image right into your pupil. So that has a lot of interest for the AR the AR community in particular, because you can eliminate that waveguide. It can also be used in AR HUD applications. Now, you need to put that image onto some kind of a diffuser so it can be magnified for the HUD. But again, very, very possible application here. So it's early stage technology. It's going to at least be a couple of years before they can get this to mass production. But this is taking optical technology and putting into a silicon fab. It's holographic optical technology. So this is really, really important stuff. So let's get a little bit closer look at their demo here. So here's their one of their 12-inch wafers. I think they're using a 22 nanometer node. You can, there I am recording here. So you can see the size of these little devices over here. Here is the holographic demo, and I was able to capture a picture of this. So I'll drop that in. As part of the video, they're showing some other demos over here. Let me go down and show you this other demo down here as well. So this demo was set up to show that the focal distance can be changed dynamically. What there's in this demo, they put a virtual image in the far field on top of one of those hotels in the distance. I guess it's Caesars, and then they can refocus it using the laptop down here to just to change the hologram, the diffraction pattern, and to refocus on this card in the front here. So that's just, and that's according to S-Wave, this is what AR developers want to use. They don't want a full holographic image. They want a holographic image where the focal plane can change from the foreground to the background or someplace in between. So that's certainly doable with software now and not optics. That's the whole advantage of having a device like this. You don't need movable lenses or other interesting components. You can do it all in software just by changing the diffractive pattern onto the spatial light modulator. So that's pretty much the story here from S-Wave. It's Chris Chinnock here for Insight Media.